Bakker, the naturopath. Thanks for coming back. Good bacteria, bad bacteria. What's the difference? I mean, how the hell would you know all this kind of stuff? Well, it wasn't all that long ago in history where scientists thought that most all bacteria were bad and needed killing, that they didn't really serve any purpose, you know, with the human digestion or human health in general. And now we know different. Now we know the bacteria are actually what keep us alive, okay? And it's the imbalance that causes the problem. So you've got so many different species of bacteria in your gut, but some have got the potential to be naughty, okay? And some have got the potential to be actually nasty, all right? And some have got the potential to kill you. So all bacteria, regardless of good or bad, need to be kept in balance, just like the human population, okay? We've got different hierarchies of people, but we've got a moral code. I don't think bacteria have really got a moral compass at all, do you? They'll do what they want to do. Even some beneficial bacteria have found to be bad when they're in very high counts, can cause problems with people. But the main difference is we generally have studied the gut to know the difference between the good, the bad, and the ugly. Clostridium perfringens, for example, Clostridium can cause really bad problems when it grows too fast. And, you know, when you get some antibiotics or some other reasons coming in there that cause the imbalance, Clostridium in young people can kill them very quickly. Salmonella is another bacteria that lives in the gut, but can very quickly become extremely high amount or be brought into the person through food poisoning, okay, and make them very, very sick. Parasites, viruses, all sorts of things can upset the balance, okay? But just remember that many of these bugs actually live in the body in very small amounts or tiny amounts or are present there already and don't create any problem until their numbers come up and shift that balance. And that often occurs with an antibiotic, often occurs with stress, often occurs with traveling when you're eating a different kind of food and you're under stress, and this can really tip the balance. And this is one of the reasons why we like people to eat cultured and fermented foods, is to tip that scale, is to get it more even. And you'll find in history, you know, if you go back since time immemorial, people have always consumed some type of fermented or cultured food, because they knew that it settled the tummy down. They didn't have microscopes or understand what, you know, lactobacillus was, but they knew that these foods improved their health. One of the simplest things you can do to avoid that imbalance and to stop the good from going ugly is to try and avoid antibiotics as much as you can in your life, okay? To try not really to have them at all, and except under extreme circumstances. Also to watch out for particularly protein sources like animals that you consume that could contain antibiotics if you eat them regularly, because they will tip the balance. So, but you shouldn't have to fear bacteria, whether they're good or bad, apart from doing crazy things in your life, like taking antibiotics. Most people tend to keep quite a good balance there. So yeah, don't fear bacteria, fear what you eat and how you live. That should really be a motto. So don't forget to click on the link below for your free Candida shopping list. Thanks for tuning in.